Emphysema is a subtype of chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Emphysema usually develops in chronic smokers and caused by damage to collagen fibers of the alveoli. And the major clinical symptom of emphysema is dyspnea. To explain the pathogenesis of emphysema, I recall that in alveoli occurs gas exchange between blood that is saturated with carbon dioxide and alveoli that are full with oxygen. Oxygen goes into the blood and carbon dioxide goes into the alveoli. And then alveoli, by expiration, push out carbon dioxide into the external environment. The airflow on expiration is equal to pressure inside the alveoli minus pressure in the external environment divided on the resistance of the airways. The problem is that in emphysema, some substances can damage our alveoli. The most common factor that causes alveoli injury is smoking. Smoke causes destruction of the collagen fibers in the alveoli membrane, and this greatly decreases elasticity of the alveoli and makes alveoli extremely fragile. With decrease in elastic recoil, the ability of the alveoli to create pressure decreases. And because of this, on exhalation, the pressure inside the alveoli decreases, and as a result, the airflow decreases. So because of decrease in elastic recoil, alveoli cannot push enough amount of carbon dioxide out of the alveoli. So some portion of carbon dioxide remains inside them. We call this phenomenon air trapping. And now, on inspiration, we already have a significant amount of carbon dioxide in the alveoli. Recall that airflow on inspiration is equal to pressure in external environment minus pressure inside the alveoli divided on resistance of the airways. And resistance is inversely proportional to the force power of radius. And once air, full with oxygen, income to the alveoli, oxygen diffuses through the alveoli membrane into the capillary, and after it blood cells deliver oxygen to peripheral tissues. And as we know, the most oxygen-dependent tissues are brain tissue and myocardial tissue. The problem is that in emphysema we have a significant amount of trapped carbon dioxide inside the alveoli, and trapped air increases the pressure inside the alveoli. As a result, the pressure difference decreases, and thereby airflow decreases. So the income of oxygen to the alveoli decreases, so in the end of inspiration, basically, instead of oxygen, we have carbon dioxide. Because trapped carbon dioxide substitutes oxygen, the amount of oxygen that diffuses into the blood decreases. As a result, the concentration of oxygen in the blood decreases, and we call this state hypoxemia. In response to local hypoxia, endothelial cells of the pulmonary capillaries begin to constrict. The problem is that at some point, vasoconstriction becomes so severe that it causes accumulation of fluid in the pulmonary arteries. The higher the volume of fluid in the pulmonary arteries, the higher the pulmonary hydrostatic pressure. And the increase in pulmonary hydrostatic pressure we call pulmonary hypertension. The lower is the oxygen concentration in the blood, the lower is the oxygen delivery to the tissues. The most sensitive tissues to hypoxia are brain tissue and myocardial tissue. Decrease in oxygen delivery to the brain tissue causes symptoms as weakness, fatigue, and lightheadedness. Decrease in oxygen delivery to myocardial tissue causes myocardial ischemia that initially decreases exercise tolerance and then can cause angina symptoms, as retrosternal pain, for example. In order to provide enough amount of oxygen to peripheral tissues, especially with physical exercises, we need to increase heart rate. So decrease in oxygen saturation stimulates chemoreceptors that in response to this increase the heart rate. Also, to increase oxygen concentration in the blood, we need to increase respiratory rate. And severe increase in respiratory rate causes shortness of breath, or we call this symptom dyspnea. Because a lot of trapped air is left in the alveoli, when the new portion of air incomes, alveoli become over-distended by excessive air. So the volume of air in the lungs increase, and this increase in total volume of air the volume of chest cavity has to increase, and as a result so-called barrel chest develops. Increase in the volume of air inside the lungs we can determine on X-ray, and we call this state hyperinflated lungs, which is a signature feature of emphysema. In response to decreasing blood oxygen concentration, kidneys begin to produce more erythropoietin that stimulates the production of red blood cells. With increasing red blood cell concentration, the concentration of hemoglobin increases, so secondary polycythemia develops. And also, decreasing elastic recoil will cause decreasing airflow that we can determine by decreasing forced expiratory volume in 1 second and by decrease in FEV1 to FVC ratio. To explain this, there is a graph. In this graph, we see volume and time. As we breath out as fast as we can, in normal condition, we breath out over 80% of air during the 1 second, and then we exhale other 20 during the next 4-5 seconds, and in the end we get so-called forced vital capacity, which is the maximal volume of air that we can exhale. The amount of air that we can breath out as fast as possible in 1 second we call forced expiratory volume. During exhalation, the airflow is equal to pressure inside the alveoli minus pressure in external environment divided on resistance created by the airways. So from this formula, we see that airflow is determined by the radius of the airways. In emphysema, damage to alveoli membrane causes decreasing elastic recoil of the alveoli, and decreasing elastic recoil affects the ability of the alveoli to create high intraalveolar pressure on expiration. With decreasing pressure inside the alveoli, pressure gradient decreases and as a result airflow decreases. And we can see this on a graph. Now in 1 second, instead of 80% of air, a person can breath out only 65, and FVC remains practically the same. Let's suppose that alveolar injury becomes even more severe. So intraalveolar pressure on expiration decreases even further. With decreasing intraalveolar pressure, pressure gradient decreases, and with decreasing pressure gradient, airflow decreases. And now, in 1 second, a person can breath out only 40%. So in emphysema, we determine the severity of the alveolar injury by decreasing forced expiratory volume in 1 second. And also, because FEV1 decreases and forced vital capacity remains practically the same, the ratio of FEV1 to FVC will decrease, and it's the second value that we most commonly use. Emphysema is a progressive disease that gradually gets worse over time. In simple terms, once damage to alveoli occurs, it's very hard to repair the damage. But with the presence of a risk factor, damage will occur again and again, and thereby the lung function this time will get progressively worse. So there is no step back, but there is always step forward.